While she charted my chest and stomach in the same way, I kept an eye on her from below. Her chin looked strong from this angle, and I could see the down on her top lip and under her ears. Occasionally her gaze met mine, and once she said, "So you're a real detective, are you?" Well, I'm afraid the real bit has faded. Then she gave me a last friendly thump to the shoulder. "Let's see if we can get a bit of colour back in you then." And the session was over. There were to be a lot more sessions, and my muscles slowly loosened and then bulked up. She started me off with exercises for the back, neck and stomach, and when she heard I had quite a few kilometres behind me on country roads, she invited me to a jog after work. "You can be the hare," I smiled. "Let's keep to the terminology of the clinic and call it the stimulus," she responded. We had run to Stora Milda Manor and around the arboretum, under trees full of history, with reddish-brown bark, splintering cones, and small, light-green plaques that informed us of their provenance. One run soon turned into many. She was in good enough shape to drag me along at first, but as the weeks on the wagon grew and I slowly felt the strength in my legs and torso return, I was in a position to challenge her. One warm afternoon in the middle of May, while the sun was playing water polo with the waves in Fana Fjord, we sat on a rock by the waterside and recovered our breath after an extra hard training shift. I had put an arm around her shoulder, and after some initial reticence, she had leaned back against my chest in such a way that I could wrap both my arms around her.